What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back. Today's video is brought to you guys by Yoohoo, and we're taking a look at one of the awesome devices that are helping keep families a bit safer, your business a bit safer, and your air quality just a bit cleaner. Now, what exactly is this able to do? Well, it's a quick little device that takes like 10 seconds to set up. You simply download an application afterwards that takes another maybe minute, and afterwards it starts monitoring your air quality, and it sends you notifications depending on maybe weird changes, and it can monitor not just your air quality but a really wide variety of things. So it has 9 air quality parameters, and it can monitor safety thresholds that are set by the EPA and the WHO. So what exactly does that mean? Well, here's what's really cool. It detects toxins and tells you the exact air quality parameters that are unhealthy all in the moment. So when your air quality, say, drops randomly, or there's carbon monoxide out of nowhere, this is the thing you want, because it will, you know, where if there's carbon monoxide and you have kids at home and maybe an older kid or a babysitter, and they don't, maybe, I don't know, the carbon monoxide detector is broken or something of those sorts, or they just don't hear it go off, this thing will also go and basically monitor all that simultaneously along with a variety of other things, and it will send you a notification saying, oh, something's off, you should probably go check on that. So what's the first thing that it will monitor? Well, the temperature, and it will send you these cute little notifications saying, hey, your temperature has been this high for this long and you should probably open a window or something of those sorts. Next off, it can also measure humidity. So it will, this is a cool way to know where, you know, like maybe your walls are getting a bit wet or something, or you're worried about why there's mold on your walls or behind your furniture. Well, humidity is pretty important, and it will actually give you another notification saying, hey, your humidity is at this particular level. Maybe you should check on that, because otherwise you might have mold growing on the backs of furniture or anywhere you really don't want it. Then there's carbon dioxide levels as well. And so if you want a good carbon dioxide level, it'll actually make you feel less nauseous, and you will have a clearer mind when levels are stable. There's also airborne chemicals and VOC that is just in the air in general, and it knows which chemicals should be there and which ones shouldn't be there, especially if this is in a kid's bedroom or something of those sorts. Then there's PM 2.5, particulate matter, and this is basically all has to do with dust buildup. So if your kids have allergies, if you have allergies, if it's just springtime, or if there's just a bunch of dust all over your house and you're trying to figure out why, and it's leading to even ear infections or just infections after a while, maybe your kids keep getting a particular infection over and over and you notice there's dust, well, maybe this thing can help you guys out, telling you, hey, you should check on this. Something's up with the air in your particular room or in your basement or wherever said kids are hanging out. We're not even done yet. Then there's nitrogen dioxide. So this is basically roadside fumes, and occasionally a lot of us live in the city, right? Like, a lot of us don't live in like good old CT or New York, where I live in upstate New York, and all of a sudden we have pretty decent air quality air. But once you go closer to Manhattan, all of a sudden the air quality isn't that great, and don't even get me started on places like Delhi or places like Beijing, where you don't even want to take one of these there because the readings are probably going to scare you. But with that said, roadside fumes are big, and you don't want something like that. And here's a scenario where, you know, you might save your kids' lives with this particular reading. Let's say it sends you a notification saying nitrogen dioxide in the air. Well, something that you might have done without realizing it, especially with push start these days on every car, is you left your car on and then you shut the garage door and you didn't realize your car was running. That can kill people. That has happened. People have died because of that, leaving their car in their garage, and then they go and they're wondering, what is up with my house? Why does it smell weird? That's a thing that can happen. There's also carbon monoxide detection. So, of course, just a little bit too much of this means you might feel a little bit of fatigue, chest pain, and if there's too much of it, this is one of the most terrifying ways that you could technically die, because carbon monoxide in the air, and it getting stuck in a room, you have all the doors shut or something of those sorts, and then you leave a stove on or something and it's producing carbon monoxide, and your carbon monoxide detector doesn't go off, you simply breathe in and you slowly feel sleepy, and then you go to sleep and you never wake up again. So that's terrifying. Make sure, even if you don't get this thing, I'm not pitching this to an extreme level, make sure your carbon monoxide detectors are working. Go inside your house, and if you don't have one, highly suggest you guys go and get that. There's also ozone, so of course this will prevent throat irritation, and it's just pretty cool. And lastly, it measures air pressure, so this can lead to headaches and whatnot. Those two, you know, they're there, but whatever. So all in all, anyone who has a family in the house, this is a really, really cool thing to have, even if it's maybe an office space, even if it's maybe just your home in general. If you really want to go all out and you have a bunch of kids, or you're running like a little school or a daycare or something, then you might want to place one of these in every single room, which is possible as well. And it will continue to measure the temperature in each room, the humidity, the carbon dioxide levels, carbon monoxide levels, whatever you need, and it will then attach colors inside of the application directly to each and every one of these. So if it's green, it means excellent. That's a nice temperature. It's comfy. It's a nice humidity level. It's good. You're not going to be getting mold. If it turns yellow, you should look into it. Nothing bad. And if it turns red, really look into it. Something is seriously off and you should really maybe either call someone in or open a few windows. Sometimes it's as simple as solving that, but you can't solve something unless you know there's an issue in the first place. Now, my favorite thing about this is that it's just really, really sleek looking. It looks kind of like a little indented Alexa, so you can place one of these next to Alexa, which is what I'm going to get to next. This thing has IFTTT, if then this, that integration, and a lot of you guys who have smart homes will be obsessed with this because you're able to automate what this thing is able to do. So every single time something happens, you can add it to a spreadsheet. So if you want to see how your air quality is changing over time, IFTTT will let you do that, and this thing integrates directly. So everything's automated and you don't have to do a single thing. Or you can do other things like tell me what the temperature is every single time my garage opens, something as random as that. Or you can connect it to other applications like Nest, and this thing will go and integrate directly with that. In fact, there's a variety of integrations directly built into this. It works with Nest, Ecobee, iRobot, SmartThings, Wemo, and Philips Hue. So you can do things like have your Philips Hue flash every single time. Maybe you can have it flash red every single time it dips below the, I don't know, your temperature dips below a certain level, and you think, okay, it dipped below this level, my kids are in that room, time to turn on the heating or something of those sorts. So that's pretty cool. And lastly, as I was mentioning Alexa, you can really just ask Alexa, what's the humidity in room number 6 where this thing is? And all of a sudden, Alexa will easily tell you that it's this particular humidity. You can ask it for a full-on summary if you want. And you can do this. Alexa, what is my carbon dioxide level?
Carbon dioxide is 1759 parts per millionth.
So all in all, guys, go ahead and check out this awesome product below. It's really easy to set up. It's really, really easy to place everywhere. It looks super sleek, and it will make you breathe easily, especially if you live in a city or you're living in an up-and-coming city that doesn't have the best air and you have a massive family, then this is probably a really, really one-time way to go and keep everyone nice and healthy in the long run and in the short run. Thank you guys for watching. This is going to be me logging off.